Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the TextBox component to it. The React TextBox is a component for editing, displaying, or entering text on forms to capture names, phone numbers, email, and more. This component has different support, like displaying text boxes with icons, floating labels, different sizing, grouping, validation states, and more. In this video, I will show you how to create a React app and add the Syncfusion React TextBox component to it. I will also show you a few of its features, like floating labels, multilines, custom styles, read-only state, and disabling the component. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the TextBox component, I type the npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-inputs -save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion ej2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. After that, import the TextBox component from the Syncfusion ej2 React Inputs package and include the TextBox component tag inside the division tag. Then set the width to 160 pixels and placeholder value to enter name. After that, I need to add the CSS reference for the TextBox component, so I open the app CSS file and remove the default styles. Then, I import the Fluent theme CSS reference. To align the component, I define the styles text align and padding. Now, let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. You can see the text box with the placeholder value enter name. Let me show you the TextBox custom style. TextBox supports three types of custom styles, namely error, warning, and success. To add custom styles, simply set the CSS class property with the appropriate classes. Here, I have set the eError class to show an error text box. In the placeholder property, I also change the value to error. To display a warning text box, let me copy-paste the TextBox component tag and change the CSS class to eWarning. I also change the placeholder value to warning. I do the same for the success text box. Here, I have used the built-in classes for the CSS class property. To align the text box, I open the app CSS file and define the margin bottom style. You can see three text boxes with the custom styles error, warning, and success. I type the word Syncfusion. You can see that the placeholder value disappears when I provide a value to the text box. I can customize the visibility of the placeholder text using the float label type property. TextBox supports three types of float label. They are always, auto, and never. Let me show you how this works. In the first text box component tag, I add the property float label type and set the value to always. In the placeholder value, I change the value to always for better clarity. In the second text box component tag, I add the property float label type and set the value as auto. In the placeholder property, I change the value to auto. In the third text box component tag, I add the property float label type and set the value as never. In the placeholder property, I change the value to never. You can see the first text box with the placeholder value always. In the second text box, it will automatically move upward when I enter the value. In the third text box, the placeholder value is never shown once I enter the value. Next, let me show you how to enable multilines for the text box. I remove the second and third text box component tags from the app.tsx file and remove the CSS class and float label type properties from the first text box component. And I change the placeholder value to enter your address. I add the multiline property and set the value to true. Now, you can enter multiline input in the text box. I can use the gripper to expand the text box. Notice that the text box allows only vertical resizing. To avoid editing the text box value, I add the property read-only and set its value to true. Then, I add the value property and set the appropriate value and remove the placeholder property. You can see the text box is in a read-only state, and the user cannot enter the value. Still, you can use the gripper to resize the text box. Finally, I will show you how to disable the text box. To do that, I add the enabled property and set its value to false. See now, the text box is in a disabled state. In this video, I have shown you how to add the text box component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.